Everybody teased Raju for being thin and lean. Sunaina, do you not feed your son properly?
Ma, I tried feeding him everything. Milk, butter, bananas and more, but nothing affects his body.
He is just like his grandfather. He too was thin and lean like him.
But grandmother, everyone calls me a stick and tease me.
It's not your fault if your body is like this. In the evening, Raju was playing football with his friend Nandu when two older kids approached them.
This is our ball.
No, this is mine. My father got it for me last night.
It was your ball till now, but from now it is ours.
No, it is ours. Hey you, stick figure, do you dare to fight us?
Come Raju, let's go.
No, that ball is mine.
Raju, we will buy a new one. Come on, let's go.
Nandu took his friend away.
What a coward, stick figure.
Hearing their words made Raju very angry. But what could he even do? Disappointed Raju looked at his reflection in the water, while Nandu threw pebbles in the pond. After some time had passed,
It is getting very late. We should go home now.
You go. I want to sit here for some more time.
Okay. But come back soon.
Nandu left. It was late in the evening and Raju decided it was time to leave. While walking through the forest, he came across a banana tree over there. And that tree was sparkling. Raju went close to the tree. And suddenly, the tree started talking.
Raju, I know you are very upset and I want to help you.
How can a tree help me?
Raju pinched himself.
Raju, I really can talk because I am a magical banana tree. And I really want to help you out.
How can you help me?
Look here, these bananas. These are magical bananas. Eat one of these bananas and then see what happens.
Raju took one banana. As soon as he peeled it, there was a glowing light. As soon as he ate it, his body grew bigger. He wasn't thin and lean anymore. He was fit and healthy like the other kids. Raju became very happy.
Thank you so much.
Now that I have helped you, you will have to help me out too.
Sure, why not?
You will have to bring some water from the lake for me.
That's it?
Yes, that's it.
Raju went over to the lake and there he filled a pot of water and took it back to the tree. As soon as he watered the tree, the soul of the tree came out of it.
You have freed me. Thank you so much.
The tree's soul went off into the sky and it remained a regular banana tree. Then Raju came back home. Looking at the transformed Raju, his mother and grandmother were shocked. His mother hugged him and he told them the story of the magical banana tree.
But grandmother, What I didn't understand is where the soul went. That tree was a cursed one, which you freed. Understood? Whatever it is, the tree changed my body. Now nobody will mess with me.
Next day, Raju went to get his ball back. He saw Balwan and Deepak playing with that ball. Raju grabbed the ball. And when Balwan and Deepak looked at him, they could not believe that it was the same Raju.
How can this happen?
He was a stick figure, right? I used to be, but not anymore. Now I will teach you to a lesson.
Raju chased them and the two boys ran in a fright. And that's how
many years ago, an old magician used to rule Tibet. His name was Yen. Yen was very kind and very helping. One day, Yen was lying in his bed, and suddenly the heavenly words echoed.
Yen, now your end is near.
After listening to this, Yen was in a bit of a bother. What will happen to Tibet after his death? That's when he went to his magic bowl and said,
Magic, magical, hey magical bowl, tell me now, who is the one like me who would inherit my throne?
In the magical bowl, it showed Vayu. Vayu could fly and control the winds. Vayu was very powerful. Seeing mighty Vayu, Yen was very happy, and suddenly Vayu turns into Agni. Agni has the power of flames. Flames couldn't burn him, and he could even control Agni. Yen was happier now. For a while he thought Agni was better than Vayu. The very moment Agni turned into Jal. Jal had the strength of water. He could walk on water. He had command over rains. And now Yen could not decide who could inherit his throne. Agni, Vayu, or Jal. Yen was in a fix. He decided that he would meet the three magicians and then take his decision. He waved his magical wand and reached the cave where the three brothers lived. The three magician brothers were eating food together.
I am Yen, the royal magician of Tibet since 60 years. I have come to meet you three over here because I have grown too old. And I want that whoever of you three is the most strongest should inherit my throne. I mean, become the royal magician of Tibet. But who is the most powerful magician amongst you three?
I am the strongest. I can burn everything, but no one can burn me.
Even I am strongest, as I can turn the direction of winds and can even fly.
And I am powerful too, because I can bring rain and can walk on the water.
I will test all of you and then decide myself who amongst you is the most powerful magician. But for this, all three of you will have to accompany me to the forest.
Next day, the three magician brothers left for forest with Yen. They were first encountered by a terrifying lion in the forest. Seeing the lion, Yen got scared. The lion intended to kill the magicians. As soon as the lion jumped over them, Agni burned him to ashes.
Very good, Agni. You saved our lives. You are powerful.
Yen liked Agni's alertness. they continued their journey. After a small distance, they were left in a hurdle of a mudland. Yen was thinking that how will they cross the mudland? Vayu saw a few stones lying nearby. He arranged them in a single row and created a way to walk on.
Vayu, that was brilliant. You created a new road. You two are very powerful.
Yen was impressed by Vayu's wisdom. After walking for a while, there was a sudden breakthrough of forest fire. Fire was spreading rapidly in the forest. Jal commanded the rains and fire was put off.
That was very nice, Jal. You saved the entire forest. Even you are very powerful.
Again, Yen was in a fix as to who among the three brothers is more powerful, Agni, Vayu, or Jal. Yen ordered them to rest near the lake for a while. While taking rest, Yen saw a parrot flying with all his zest. Then Yen saw a snake crawling with all his vigor. And then he saw in the nearby lake a fish, which was swimming with all its audacity. And now Yen realized,
you three brothers are different, like the creatures living in this forest. See this, the snake, parrot, and the fish. Neither the snake can fly, nor can the fish crawl, and nor can the parrot swim. Everyone has their own speciality. All of you are strong in your own ways. I will take all three of you to Tibet, where you three will inherit my throne.
Yen could not decide who among the three brothers was the most powerful because all three were different from each other. Yen also realized that he could not compare the brothers with one another, as everyone was master of their own strengths. Hence it is said, everyone should dance to their own tune. We should never compare ourselves to others.